Thrilled to be joined now by a guy I just talked to a little while ago when this season was getting underway for the Big Three. You know him, you love him. It's Ice Cube. He's done so much in the music, movie industry, and he's still making his way in the sports industry. Ice Cube joining me on this Tuesday morning. Cube, how you doing, sir?
I'm pretty fair for square. How you feeling?
That's amazing. Yeah, man, I'm doing good. It's always good to talk to you. How's the season gone? I mean, we know we're about to get ready to start the Big Three playoffs this Sunday. Overall, just how would you assess how this season's gone for you guys?
Amazing season on the court. You know, our best competition, our best athletes, you know, since the start of the Big Three, from top to bottom. So the league has actually tightened up when it comes to competition. You really don't know who's going to win every time you go into the gym. So that's right where you want the league to be. You know, nobody's running away with it.
That's awesome. Have you had a favorite moment of this season so far?
A lot of cool moments. You know, I think our game-winning shots are always incredible. You know, seeing Kevin Murphy hit a four-pointer to win the game, you know, when they were down by, 4 points. They was down by 2 points, and it was like 48-46, and he hits a four-pointer to win the game. So exciting. That's what you want Big Three games to be. You want it to, you know, the way it's set up, the rules. You want guys to be able to come back from a big deficit and actually have a chance to win the game.
Yeah. I mean, the quality of play it seems like it improves every single year. You've got real NBA players here. And for me, it's been fun. I think I told you before, being in the Sacramento area, there's so many guys with ties to the Sacramento Kings. And you look at just the teams that are still left in this playoffs. And one of them, I mean, you've got Nancy Lieberman's team. She's an assistant coach with the Kings. You know, she's got Royce White and Katino Mobley, and they're going up against, you know, three-headed monster, Reggie Theus's team. And so many just guys that have connections to this area. How fun is it for you to see these guys still able to compete at such a high level?
It's amazing, you know, you see these guys that's been out the league for a long time, you know, like a Reggie Theus or, Nancy, she's still coaching, but they haven't played in a while. But to see their competitive juices, like, you know, they're damn near ready to run out there on the court themselves. So that's fun because that's what we remember these guys are, you know, as competitors. And see Dr. J and Rick Barry, you know, arguing at the refs. It's just fun. And our players, you know, they respect the coaches so much. They play hard. They play together. And you have to have your skills in order to actually be successful in the Big Three. Nowhere to hide. Got to man up. Got to D up. Got to accept the challenge. And so it's been amazing to see this league develop.
I wonder if you were like maybe the rest of us, me and my friends. I think I got the biggest kick this season, and it happened this past week when Katino Mobley started running his mouth towards Rick Mahorn, which Katino Mobley's a former King, man. I covered him in Sacramento, and here he is going after one of the NBA bad boys. Was this were you about as surprised as that as I was?
Not really. You know, these guys are extremely competitive. And, you know, Katino and Rick, they love each other. You know, where they've been part of the league since day one. But they want to win. Nobody wants to hear the smack talking when you lose. So the competitive juices, they do come out. I love the passion. I like for people to see that it's real, that it's not, these guys are not, they're not getting rich in the Big Three. It's all about winning. It's all about being the best. It's all about showing the people what you still got. And so to see that come out in such a competitive way, in such a meaningful game, it reminds me of the championship in 2018 when Katino and Power almost got into a fight with Three's Company. And it actually propelled them to the championship. So it's right with the doctor order, man. We want trash talking. We want it to be physical. We want you in each other's faces trying to win.
it's awesome this week, especially comes up the playoffs on Sunday. You have any kind of prediction? Do you have anything, any feel for how these games are going to go?
I really don't. You know, you would think Trilogy was the clear favorite. They won the championship last year. They're going for a repeat, third title in 5 years. But the Aliens beat them this year. Kind of beat them at their own game, which is the bully ball. And so, you know, will it happen again? And then you have three-headed monsters who are on a mission. They've been in the playoffs every year, but never won a championship. So, you know, they was up by 13 points in the championship last year at halftime and lost the game. So they have a lot to prove. And Power, you know, led by Nancy Lieberman as the coach. You know, she's ferocious. Her and Coutinho, they was champions in 2018 and haven't sniffed the championship since then. So got four hungry teams ready to see who can do it.
I can't wait. And the championship comes up right after that. And this year, first time for an all-star game. I can't wait to see some of these guys, especially guys like Royce White, who's kind of, you know, rebuilt his career and probably will be in the all-star game. I mean, I can't imagine he wouldn't be. How much are you looking forward to that?
Oh, yeah, man. Extremely fun to be able to produce an all-star game before a championship game. Before, it was a consolation game, you know, who's fighting for third place. But nobody wanted to play that game, you know. When we had the consolation games, nobody really wanted to play. So we got rid of that to bring in an all-star game. It's perfect. Everybody wants to play. And then you get to see the league's best, you know, before the championship game. So it's unique. It's fun. And having the Big Three, we're able to do that. And then we got a celebrity game before that. So that's going to be fun and funny to see guys, you know, going at it, competing in the Big Three style of play.
Any names there? Are you going to be playing as well?
I'm not playing. I'm retired. You know what I mean? I'm going to be watching. But we got a few names. We'll see who jump on the plane. You know, everybody say they're coming, but you know how these celebrities are. You got to damn near get their ass in a headlock to get them on that plane. So once we make sure they're in Atlanta, we'll start dropping the names.
I love it. I before I get out of here, I know I saw just last week it was announced that you're going to be coming right back through this area to perform. You're going to have the Holiday Jam at Golden One Center. I saw you last time you came through Golden One Center. Looking forward to seeing that show. What can people expect if they've never come out to a Cube show before?
You know, me dropping the hits. You know, I don't play around. Don't waste your time. I come out there and I drop hits from NWA all the way through my solo career. You know, we might drop a Mount Westmore track here and there. Just everything in between. West Side Connection stuff. I'm going to have my man Dub C with me, of course. So it's going to be a California party. You know what I mean? You know how we do.
Of course. Cube, I can't thank you enough. It's great to catch up with you again. Best of luck with the playoffs and the championship here with the Big Three, and look forward to speaking with you either later down the road or maybe next season.
Appreciate it, man. Talk to you later.
Sounds good. Thanks again.
Yeah.